Hello everyone. In this video, we will be solving the question median priority queue. Now, in this question, I need you to pay close attention. As you can see, it has been given the difficulty level as hard. And it does take up a concept that requires a certain amount of understanding of priority queues. So, brief on priority queue. Basically, in a priority queue, we can, as we know, get either the minimum element of or well the elements that we have in a priority queue or the maximum element depending on the type of priority queue we have. And in this question, what we're expected to implement is the concept of a median priority queue, which means that say we have these elements 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So the median of this list would be 30. And that's basically what we have to return in case we have to remove an element or say we have to peak the element. Then in this case, we will return the median element. Similarly, in the case of an even priority queue, we'll simply consider the lower number as our median element. Now, how are we going to do that using the concept of priority queues? Simply speaking, we'll take two priority queues known as, well, we'll call them left and right. And using these two priority queues, we are supposed to return the median value. Now, how are we going to do that? As we can see, we are supposed to implement four functions. One is add, one is remove, then peak, then size. And we have our two priority queues defined for us. One is left, one is right. This collections.reverse order basically says that, you know what, the left priority queue that you have, it is a max priority queue. That means that when we remove an element, it will return the maximum value that we have in that priority queue. And the right one is a min priority queue. That means that, well, it returns the minimum element. Say if these elements, all of them are inside a max priority queue and we remove an element, it will return 50. But in a min priority queue, it will return 10 as it is the smallest value. So left will be the maximum priority queue, right will be the minimum priority queue. Now we're supposed to implement add, remove, peak and size. So let's talk about add first. When we add an element inside this entire structure of left and right priority queues, basically the user won't know that we have two priority queues, right? The user has to see them as a single priority queue that returns a median value. Our implementation is dependent on two separate queues. That's a different thing. So when we're adding, by default, we'll add our element in the left priority queue. Say the order of input is 10, 20, 30, 40, and 50. If I'm at 10 right now, I'll put 10 inside my left priority queue. Then the approach that we're taking to actually solve this problem is that let me take in one more input, 20. Let me put that in here. So the approach is that, well, one, condition number one, the size of left minus size of right priority queue should not be greater than one. The difference of them is allowed to be one at the maximum. Right now, we put one element in here. Size was one. Here, the size is zero. So if you're inputting 20, say I put it here, the size would become 2, the size of the right priority queue would remain as 0. This condition is not fulfilled, in which case we will do something called balancing the priority queues. We'll balance the priority queues. Now how are we going to do that? Okay, so we have these elements with us. We check if the size, if this condition is fulfilled, that is this, that this number of elements in the left is greater than the number of elements in the right, and the difference between them is 2. In that case, let's say difference is equal to 2 or greater than 1. In that case, what we do is that we remove one element from the left priority queue. This is just a pseudo code, and we actually add it to the right priority queue. So we remove one element from the left, we add it here. These are balanced. Another condition in which we could have a disbalance is when the number of nodes, the number of elements inside the right priority queue is actually more than the number of elements in the left priority queue. That is size. Of the right priority queue. Minus 1 is equal to size of left priority queue. Or basically, if size of the right priority queue is greater than size of the left priority queue. In that case, this is also not allowed. In that case, we will also balance. And in this condition, so this is how you balance condition 1. Condition 2, how you balance it? Well, it's the exact opposite. If this is the condition, then we remove one element from the right. Remove one element from the right and add it to the left. That's how we balance. That's how we basically add elements to the priority queue. But one thing we need to make sure is, one thing we need to determine is which priority queue to add at what point in time. Of course, we can balance it if the size is inappropriate, but how do we actually add it? We add it by determining this one factor, that is, if our element is less than, okay, before I go to the actual approach, I say that the left half, that is the left priority queue, should store the smaller half of the total elements that we have. Smaller half. The right one should store the larger half. This should help you understand how we will add the elements here. And the maximum size that left half can have is, well, total number of elements divided by 2 plus 1. And maximum size for this one would be n by 2. And now, when we add the elements, we see that if the element, the maximum element in this left array is greater than the element we are trying to input, say we're going to input 30, we check if 30 is less than the maximum element in the left priority queue, we add it in, well, the left priority queue, but if it's not, we add it in the right priority queue. We have 30 here. Now we check the size, we check for sizes, whether they're appropriate or not. We see that the size of the right is actually more than the size of the left, which we don't want. This is a condition which we will explain why we are implementing. So I remove 30 from here, I add 30 here. Then I put 40. For 40, I check again. And let's have another input, say 15. For 40, I check again whether it is smaller than the greatest element in the left half, and it is not. So I put it in the right half. I check for sizes. The size of the two priority queues seem to be same. Even if left had one more element, it would have been fine. So we do nothing about the balancing. And if that is not the case, let's see what we get as one more input. We have 15 here. I check whether 15 is smaller than the highest than the maximum element in the left priority queue. The answer is yes. So we add 15 here. And so now I decide that I want to remove the median element. I implement remove here. Let's create a section here for the remove. For removing, it's pretty simple. We check if the left priority queue has greater than 0 elements. That is, well, it is not empty. If yes, then we simply remove the element from this priority queue. Since it is the maximum priority queue, it will always return the highest element, which is 30. And in our example, 30 would be the correct answer for our median. That's basically what we do. And after 30 is done, we check for balancing again, if the size are appropriate or not. And since they are balanced this time, let us, well, try to remove another one. I say I remove once again. I get 15, because 15 is the highest element in the left priority queue. When we're removing or when we're trying to get the top element, we always check the left priority queue. That is the major crux of this problem. And now, when we remove 15 from here, we get 10, we get 20 and 40. Now we check for sizes. We see that condition 2 is not fulfilled because size of the right priority queue is more than the size of the left priority queue. So we do balancing. Let's remove this from here for clarity. We do balancing. In balancing, we see that, well, since we were not fulfilling condition 2, we add in the left. What do we add in the left? The element that we're removing from the right. The right priority queue removes the smallest element. And we'll add this in our left priority queue. And if we remove it once again, we have 10, 20, and 40 with us. And so when we remove, once again, we call the remove operation, we get the output as 20, which is the median, which will be removed from here. That's basically what we have to implement. So majorly, we need to check for sizes and we need to balance appropriately. And we always get our answer on the left priority queue. We always check for size difference. And then we balance. If needed, otherwise, we simply get our answer from left priority queue. So we are storing elements in a way that we always get our median element in the left priority queue. In case of odd, we have an extra element in the left priority queue, which will be our answer. In case of even, well, we already demonstrated how that works. In fact, we demonstrated both cases. So now we should try to implement this, assuming that the explanation is clear to you. For adding, by default, we add it in the left priority queue first. That is, if left.size is equal to 0, or the value that we're inputting is less than left.peak. That is, the highest value in the left priority queue should be greater than the value we're inputting. If that is the case, this value belongs in the first half. So we add it. Otherwise, the value belongs in the right half. And at the end of every addition, we balance our priority queues. Let's write the balance function now. Say we have public void balance. I have left and right with me. Actually, I don't think we need to do this since our variables are actually defined as class variables. We don't need to input any parameters here, I'm assuming. So now that we have that cleared for us, what we'll do is we'll check if left.size minus right.size is actually greater than 2, so greater than 1. If the difference is 2, I balance elements in the way that I remove element from my left priority queue and I add it to the right priority queue. Otherwise, we check if right dot size is greater than left dot size, which is not a condition that is acceptable to us. In that case, we balance again in the way that we add element to the left. Which element? The element that we remove from the right priority queue, which will be the least element of the right priority queue. That's how we balance basically. And removal is pretty simple. What we do is we check if there's a condition, if the left, if the priority queue is empty and we don't have a median value to return, we write underflow. So if left dot size is equal to 0, then we print underflow and we return minus 1. Otherwise we return left dot whatever we get when we remove an element from the left priority queue, which will be the median value, and then we finally balance. Actually, this won't be correct. So what we need to do is we need to store this value in a variable first. Say I have int val. We remove first. We balance our priority queues, because on removal there will be a difference in sizes. Sizes will be updated, so we need to balance accordingly, and then we return this value that we have with us. Peak, basically what we need to do in peak is that we need to just get the value. We don't need to remove it. We just need to get the median value. Function will be similar. Instead, we have peak with us, and we don't need to balance because there will be no updation in sizes. In case of size, well, we simply return left dot size plus right dot size. And I think that solves our problem. Let's try to run this and see what we get. It's accepting. Let's try to submit this. The answer is correct. That's basically how you solve median priority queue. Now, the solution is basically complete, but in case you were still confused, I'll summarize the solution for you. So we have two priority queues, left and right. In those left and right priority queues, we can add elements, we can remove, we can peak the top element, peak the median element, I'm sorry, and we can get the size. So for by default, when we are adding an element, we add it to the left. By default, add to the left priority queue. And we also add to left in case the value is less than the highest element in the left priority queue, which will be get by left dot peak, since this is the max priority queue. Otherwise, we enter, we add it Otherwise, we add it to the right priority queue, and then we balance. I've already discussed balancing in detail, so won't go in there. Removal. In removal, we simply remove from left priority queue, because that is where our answer will always be, as we've discussed why. And then after removal, we also need to balance again. Size will be pretty simple. Size is basically the size of the number of elements that we have in the left priority queue plus size of the right priority queue. And that's basically how you solve median priority queue. And hope you found this solution useful. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this useful, then leave a like, drop a comment, and feel free to subscribe. Thank you for watching.